Welcome, sir. We are very grateful for your attendance.
Are you the man? I, Dr. Manye Nelson. Swear with this Bible that the evidence I shall give before this committee shall be the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help me.
Doc, please, can you give your full name again to the committee?
My name is Dr. Mensa Manye.
Is it M-A-N-Y-E?
My name is Dr. Mensa Manye.
Can you spell the Manye, please?
M-A-N-Y-E.
Please, where do you work? Which hospital?
Edra Government Hospital.
Please, what's your designation at the hospital? Your position?
Yeah, I'm the medical superintendent of the hospital.
Can you tell the committee how long you've been there as a doctor?
6 years ago.
Do you have any specialization as a doctor?
No, I'm a general practitioner.
Do you live at Ajira?
Yes.
So, as a resident, in your estimation, how would you describe the general nature of the town in relation to security?
The atmosphere of the town in relation to security is quite threatening.
So, were you at Ajira on the 29th of June this year, 2021?
Yes.
I believe as a hospital, by all means, you would have several patients in a day. But I'm going to ask you this question in special reference to patients who were brought there as a result of some shooting in Ajira on the 29th. Please tell the committee if you have any information on these patients in relation to this incident.
Thank you. On the 29th June 2021, around 12 p.m. was preparing to go for an operation or CS. A group of nurses rushed to me in the theater. That some people were shot during a demonstration. In Grattan, and as a result, they were rushed to the hospital emergency unit.
Before this time, had you personally heard about any demonstration or any such disturbances going on in the town?
No, not really.
Before, the nurses told you that some persons have been brought as a result of this demonstration. Have you heard that day that something of that sort was going on, some demonstration was going on?
Yeah, I heard there was a demonstration in town. Before, in the afternoon, the nurses rushed to me with that report. So I quickly abandoned the operation and rushed to the emergency unit. Based on the narration, I felt that one needed an urgent attention. Yeah. Having gotten to the place, I saw two young men, one by name Abdul Yusuf, age 25 years, who was brought in dead. Which means he died before arrival. Yeah, and the other, they were two, the other person was also rushing. He was gasping. That is having difficulty in breathing. And sweating profusely. So quickly, on my examination of the first deceased, that Abdul Yusuf, I realized as the reporters or some of the demonstrators said that they were gunned down, I saw a gunshot injury at the left, at the back of the left upper chest. Penetrating into the chest. And also an injury at the left shoulder joint with a fracture of the humerus. The fracture of the humeral joint means the left arm joint was fractured or broken.
Now, Doc, from what you saw of that patient who was then deceased, could you tell the committee whether the person was shot from the front or the back? The exit and entry?
As narrated, the gunshot injury was at the back of the left upper chest. We had the chest, the upper, the middle, and the lower. So at the back of the left upper chest, at the region of the scapula, that the bone, the flat bone, and also another hitting the left humeral joint, leading to fracture of the humeral bone.
The bone in the arm, the biggest bone in the arm, is that
the
one?
It's at the joint area, the shoulder joint, somewhere okay. There.
Right. Please continue.
So, he is passed, so I left him at the couch. We covered him, having seen the sort of injury he sustained. I quickly rushed to the second person. Earlier, I said there were two. The second person, what I saw was also at the back, at the middle part of the chest, the left area, there was also an injury, gunshot injury at the left, at the middle part of the chest.
So, for that one too, for clarity's sake, where, in your estimation, was the entry point, the back or the front of the chest?
The entry was at the back.
The back?
Yes. He was also bleeding profusely as the first who passed. In fact, all their shirt were soaked in a pool of blood. I realized the second one was getting into shock. So, quickly,
he was getting into
shock. It was what collapsed.
Okay.
Gasping, sweating profusely, with a very fast rate of pulse. It means, so we quickly resuscitated, giving enough fluid, ordering for blood, and the necessary oxygen to be given in order to revive the client. Due to the profuse bleeding out, and I realized what was happening is that inside the chest, he looked so pale, which obviously showed there was an internal bleeding. Very, very pale.
Please continue.
While doing those resuscitation, the nurses on board, everybody running here and there, we lost the patient within 10 minutes of arrival. So there is an internal injury with internal bleeding, internal organ damage precisely around the lung with internal bleeding, which could not actually permit a survivor. So that one also passed. We have to leave him and concentrate on the... Okay. And concentrate shortly. Others were brought. I think two young ones were also brought. One is Louise. The other one, Awa, Miss Bao.
You didn't get to know their ages. Since you said you were young, I don't know about how
their
young.
Ages.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Awa, Miss Bao is 16 years. Louise, Atipa. He is 19 years. Along his bow, both of them, they were all bleeding. But along his bow was bleeding profusely from the thigh.
The thigh.
The femur bone.
The thigh.
The femur bone. He sustained severe injury at the femur bone towards the knee joint, precisely the right femur bone.
Which is in ordinary parlance located in the thigh.
That's the thigh bone.
Please continue. And the other one, the Louise, where was he?
Yeah, I haven't finished with that.
Sorry, okay.
there were also multiple injuries at the muscles of the thigh of Awa. Actually, he also entered into shock. Profuse bleeding. Bleeding profusely, sweating, also looks very pale. So quickly, the resuscitation team were on board, setting two IV lines, getting the infusion. Giving him enough infusion, and also quickly, we took blood, full blood count for grouping a cross match in order to know the blood group and also transfuse appropriately. So we did our best, we packed and bandaged the Awa, the one with the femur fracture, the thigh bone fracture. The fracture was located at the knee joint of the right femur, the knee joint of the right thigh. It was a multiple fracture. We splint the thigh. Splint means you bring a long board in order to actually prevent the broken bone from dangling.
So, Doc, tell us, for the treatment, eventually, what did you do?
Oh, treatment, resuscitation, that is the resuscitation. Resuscitation entails giving enough infusion. As the person bleeds, he loses a lot of fluid and the blood as well.
Did you give him any stitches? Was he operated upon? Was there any stitches? Stitches?
Oh, we did.
Okay.
Yes. In order to secure hemostasis or to prevent more bleeding, we switched, we packed in order to secure hemostasis, that to prevent more bleeding. And finally, we split the thigh. After the X-ray of our Miss Bao.
Look, with all due respect, we would have loved to take the details, but we want to just know he was brought in injured, and we want to know the path of injury. And then eventually, if you could tell us eventually what happened to him, so that we move on to the next.
Yeah, exactly. That's what.
Okay. So eventually,
after
was
that,
he still?
We took an X-ray to know the extent of injury. Where we realized, there were multiple fractures at the right femur joint. There were multiple fractures at the right femur joint, and based on the nature of the fracture. The following day, and we gave a lot of treatment in terms of IV antibiotics. The next day, after assessing him, I referred him to. They preferred the acupuncture, but when they got there, they also referred them to Confirmatory Teaching Hospital. That's what he about our.
And the Louise guy, the Louise, also, where was he injured?
Can I talk about the disease right before the Louise?
Okay.
The Louise also sustained an injury, a gunshot injury, at the right, above the hernia crest that is at the waist, just above the waist, the bone there, into the abdomen, precisely the pelvic region. When I probed into it, it went and opened at the iliac fossa region of the same abdomen. That's the right iliac fossa region.
No, please help us.
Okay, sorry.
Okay, you can give the medical terminologies and then you come to the layman's.
Okay, that's way. The language I normally speak.
Yes.
That would be really
because those typing would may not even be able to type the correct spelling for us.
Okay. So. I said it was shot at the back. Above the bone, the waist bone here, it entered and then came to the lower part of the pelvis here. Around this place, this is what we call the iliac fossa. If it's the right side, we say right iliac fossa. And he was also having profuse bleeding. Due to the extent of bleeding, and when I probed into it, and where I saw the injury was actually going, I knew internally they were more damaged than what we're seeing physically. So quickly, I also called for an ambulance and referred him that day. By that of hour, he left the following day. But we resuscitated him very well. By God's will, all of them got to their destination. That is Kofono Chetiki Hospital. I know very well that one also we took an X-ray to that effect. At Konfanoche, I know there will be more investigation before exploratory laparotomy will be carried on.
Now, were they the only two injured persons who were brought to your facility?
Pardon?
Were they the only two injured persons who were brought to your facility?
No.
Okay. How many more, if you can remember?
In all, there were four, those who were injured. But the other two were not severe. So we treated and they are gone. Okay. They were gone. Okay. But however, we had so many ladies or women of the disease, about six, who also went into shock, they collapsed. Having heard that
were there relatives of both deceased or one of them? Were there women of the two deceased or one of them? There were two deceased now.
Yeah, there were two deceased.
Okay, so both of them, they are family members?
Yes, both okay. of them. In addition, okay. their really close relatives also followed. So we had six of them who collapsed. Okay. But God being so great, we resuscitated them. They were fine. And we discharged all of them.
Okay. Apart from you treating patients, apart from your professional duties of treating these patients, can you tell the committee if anything unusual or anything else happened at the hospital that day because of this demonstration? Yes, the committee has received some form of testimonies that there were a large crowd of people that took to the hospital that day and put pressure on you such that you had to call in the police. You tried to call the police, but you couldn't get the police. And so you were forced to release the two bodies without post-mortem being conducted. Was that the case?
Yeah, thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.
Yes. The crowd that came there was so huge. It wasn't easy. So, as usual, things of this nature is a national issue. And when it's happening, like as a doctor, you have to take all the necessary precautionary measures and actually advise for the body to be kept at the morgue for any further investigation. So after the death of the two, they came in and said they want to pick the body. I said, no, we don't do it like that. We have measures to take before actually releasing the body. But they realized I was delaying their time. And I said, oh, even for what happened, I have to call even the police. They will come, we both sit down, we'll get the relative, write their name, and for possible transfer of the body to the morgue, and we arrange for postmortem. It was then that, hey, they shouted that they would burn down the hospital if I try, and also our lives. They were actually what beat us very, very well, and even leading to death. I also started calling the police. And at that condition, they could also not come. And because of the agitation, release the body, release the body. Quickly. And reluctantly, I have to release the body to preserve the hospital from being burnt and also save the life of myself and myself. So I quickly released the body.
Was it a demand for both bodies or just one body?
For both. Because one died just 10 minutes after the one who died before they brought. Demand for both.
And do you remember which of the police that you called? Police station, is it station officer, district commander, division?
Yes, I called the crime officer also. I spoke to them and yes.
The crime officer of the station, the district or the division?
Yes, of the station.
The station.
Yes. And due to the crowd was really charged. And when I mentioned the police, it was that it annoyed them the more. So quickly, that's where they said, hey, doctor, give us our body. And then quickly I have to release it.
Okay. So as of now, are you aware whether the bodies have been buried?
Long ago.
Okay, so do you have any more evidence or do you have any documentary evidence that you would want to produce to the committee?
I think all the evidences I have, I gave with my writer, a medical report, I gave it to the police, which they submitted.
As part of
honorable citizens.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
And maybe some X-rays, but these ones.
Thank you very much, Doctor. The panel members will ask you some questions. Thank you.
Doctor, once again, welcome.
Thank you.
Yes, I believe with your experience, you have come into contact with gunshot wounds several times. Yes, can you tell us whether from the injuries that you saw on the two deceased persons, whether from the injury, it was a close range shot?
Yeah. What I can say, it wasn't so close like that.
Okay. Can you help us? Do you think, in your estimation, it would be of about a distance of 50 meters, 20 meters, 30 meters, or the distance, looking at the level of injury. You know, when somebody is shot from close range, you can easily determine from the extent of injury and penetration. Yes. Can you give us an idea as to?
I can say I am not expert in
not an expert in
and the distance, but what I know is that it was quite a distance.
Quite a distance. Yes. Then also, you said the bullet penetrated from the back of the deceased person. From the way you saw the injury, would you say that the person who shot these two individuals was standing behind them or in front?
No, at a distance behind.
At a distance behind.
Yes.
Well, and that of those who got injured but did not die, what is your view about the extent of the injury and the distance?
Yes, I think almost the same.
The same.
Yes. Thank you.
Yes, the youth, you said, came to the hospital, demanded that you release the bodies. So, can you tell us whether the bullets were still in the bodies before they were released to them?
Thank you. That much I may not be able to tell. The surviving one, we took an X-ray.
Okay.
Those one, yes, if we had taken an X-ray, I would have been able to know the bullet. Some of the bullets are still in situ.
Okay.
Since we didn't take X-ray, I can't comment.
So the surviving ones, did you find the bullets in the legs?
Yes.
Did you remove them?
I referred them for pathology specialists to undertake that.
Oh, okay. Oh. Thank you. My other colleagues will ask.
Welcome, Doc, and congratulations.
Thank you.
I personally salute you for the efforts you made.
Thank you.
Any other medical officer would do, so I congratulate you.
Thank you.
Is that your first experience at such both crime and injury?
For injuries, uncountable, Edra. Injury every day, even today, in terms of RTA, multiple fractures, head injuries, divided, uncountable. In short, hunters, uncountable.
That's why we need to congratulate you.
Thank you.
Right. It's unfortunate we were unable to extract any of the bullets. We wanted to find out whether the type of bullet is a military bullet or somebody shot from the crowd. But you may not be able to answer that question because, one, you are not the ballistic expert, and two, you didn't extract any bullets. But tell me, you were battling between your professionalism and the exigencies, the demand of the hour. If you hadn't released the bodies, your hospital would not have been there. You yourself may not be alive today.
Thank you.
Thank you. But then, for criminal investigation, for rule of law, we should have insisted on your professionalism. But as I said, you put it. Can you give the committee some kind of suggestion as to how we should curb this? Because it looks as though evidence is gone forever.
Right.
People, it will happen and happen again. But we want to stop this. So can you advise us a little as to what we should tell government in such circumstances?
Yes, thank you. What I can say is that if Edra security or police were well resourced and trained very well, I think they will be able to contain and manage this thing peacefully. because I realize even cars and all those is a problem to them. And the number of staff from discussion with the crime officer and the commander, they don't even have the staff, the number of staff, let alone coming to the house, please. Because of that, and with maybe not having logistics, that's the reason why they could not even follow the ground to that place for fear. So if they have the necessary logistics, I think they'll be able to manage peacefully without anything, and also the training should be well equipped so that next time they will manage things maybe higher than this, but without any casualty.
They will save the doctor from.
And I will be saved.
Do you think we need a legislation or application of existing legislation in matters like this? Do you think we need a legislation if it's not there? Or if it is there, application of that legislation to forestall a situation where you have to release bodies even though they are criminal cases? Do you think we need a legislation in the country?
Yes. If it is there, it ought to be enforced. By the enforcement, it means if you know that people will come and demand a body, then the training and the how people should be well equipped to prevent that ought to be enforced. But if the legislation is not there, then it ought to be, you know, come to enforcement.
Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you so much.
Doc, whilst you were there any policemen who came around that time to try to talk to any of the victims? Perhaps before you referred them, for example.
Thank you so much. I cannot, because that at the time, the euphoria, everybody, you can't see one. So since I didn't see policemen enter the room, in fact, I cannot also say that maybe they were standing somewhere, but I didn't see any in the room.
So, to the best of your knowledge, no policeman had arrived or CID to talk to the two injured persons?
Yeah, I haven't seen any there.
Okay. We are very grateful to you, Doc. We will make the necessary recommendations in respect of your concerns. We thank you. May the good Lord take you back to Accra. Continue to serve Mother Ghana in that capacity. We all pray that we will get to the state that Ghanaians will understand that in such situations they should allow the medical personnel to do their lawful duties.
Thank you.
Yes, because if we need justice to be done, definitely, we don't have to take away pieces of evidence that will help justice delivery to be stopped. We thank you. God bless you.
Thank you so much. God bless you too.